people sense they're being kept in the dark purposely. Furthermore, there is no consensus as to whether the objectives are even realistic. Is this a war that can be won? Some say no. Are we just going through the motions so certain people can cover themselves?
Honey, it's on.
Some say yes.
Hey, I'm coming.
How is this war fought? It's like fishing. We use bait. Actually, the bait is spread over our city at night like a glaze. This is very discriminative bait.
Do you have to wear your glasses
smart
on TV?
Bombs that destroy one thing, but nothing else. The bait is already established in Los Angeles.
Baby?
Honey, what's the matter? Do you have a bad dream?
Necessary war.
Oh, come on, sweetie. Let's watch Daddy on TV.
But if it's not,
I'll snuggle.
What happened? Helicopters?
This is Howard Finnegan.
He's just
frightened. The thoughts to make you think.
Casey? You are going to be late for school, young man. Now, do you want me to drive you?
No, I'll walk.
You sure? All right, kisses. Honey, you all right?
I'm fine.
Wait. I can get your stuff. Here, wait up. Come on, let's get in my car.
No, I'm fine. My mom doesn't want me to go in a car with strangers.
No, wait a minute. I have to get here. Let me give you a ride home. Make sure you're okay.
I'm fine, I'm for sure.
Hi.
I'd like to order a birthday cake.
Sure, with birthdays, I keep adding up, huh?
Mr. Cake?
Thanks.
Oh, I've got a couple ideas here. Okay, this is what I'd like. Here, you see?
It says, happy birthday, Casey.
Excuse me?
Yes.
Casey.
And is that supposed to
Hi,
be
Mrs. Schwarzmeyer.
Yes, that's a baseball bat. I don't draw very well.
I came to pick up the cake for
Debbie. Are you sure you want this? Because I have some very nice baseball designs.
And I think it's prepaid.
No, if you like this, I can do it.
I like this.
Sure.
I like this. He's starting in the leagues. We're real excited, so.
That's really sweet. His name is Casey, and he plays baseball.
Yeah.
School? Honey? What happened?
I got hit by a car.
What? What do you mean you got hit by a car? Where? How? Casey, now you tell Mom exactly what happened.
I got hit in the back and knocked down hard.
Well, how'd you get home?
Walked.
Well, Casey, let me look at you.
Howard? Oh. We have a phone call. It's your wife. I think you've got time.
Excuse me.
Got some great stuff coming, good footage coming in on the satellite. 3 minutes worth
Hello.
Of
Hello.
Howard?
Yeah.
Casey got hit by a car. He's all right, though.
You got it. What do you mean, hit by a car?
When? Where is he?
Well, he's here. He's home with me. He's all right. He's not hurt.
Annie, listen to me. Now, just calm down. Start from the beginning and tell me exactly what happened.
Well, I put him in bed and he fell fast asleep. He's all right, I'm sure.
I mean, why'd you let him go to sleep? You shouldn't have done that, honey. Jesus Christ, I mean, who hit him? How did this happen?
I don't know. I came home and he was here. He went to sleep. I should let him sleep, shouldn't I?
No, you wake him up
and you take him to the emergency room. You got to get him looked at right away.
Call Bob Winslow. No, wait, I'll call him.
Just hang up the phone. I'll call you right back, okay?
All right. I understand.
Okay, don't worry.
Everything's going to be all right. He's going to be fine.
Make sure they do the neuro checks every half hour and diligent sectioning. Mr. Finnegan. He's resting comfortably. That's good. We'll let him sleep. That's the best thing for him right now. He's got a small blood clot, little brain swelling, but it probably won't require any surgery. He's aspirated, but we're not too concerned about that.
Aspirate? What is that?
He's got some fluid in his lungs. Listen, we'll keep a close eye on him, okay?
He knows what he's doing. It's going to be all right. Thanks.
His vital signs are good. We're just going to have to wait till he wakes up.
Was there something we could do? Something we should do?
You can wait. There's a waiting room down the hall. He's smoking out on the porch if you want to smoke.
Okay.
He may be waking up soon. You want to be here when he does.
Yeah, well, listen, how long you think it'll be?
Well, you never know with these things. Listen, I just want you to do whatever makes you feel comfortable.
Sure. So why don't you go home and get some rest? I mean, I'll call you if there's any change.
No, you go. I'll stay. You go. You go rest up. You've got things at the station. I'm all right.
I can make some calls. Probably a good time. But I'll take the number of the payphone here. Right?
That's a good idea.
Yeah. I mean, sometimes it takes forever to get through here.
Could you bring me some shoes and flats and a sweater and maybe some mail? Magazines or something?
Yeah. It's going to be all right.
Mrs. Finnegan, please.
Sorry, she's not here right now. Who's this?
This is Mr. Bitkow. She placed an order today, and I just wanted to make sure I was clear about what she wanted. Her drawing's a little bit.
Yeah, well, she isn't here right now. Why don't you call her back next week, right? No, you may not. And whatever it is, why don't you just cancel it and stop calling here, all right? Now, we got a problem here. We don't need the line tied up with unimportant stuff.
Either you give me an answer now...
But fuck you, asshole. Fuck you!
Numbers look good.
Yeah?
I don't think it's good he keeps sleeping like this. I don't think that's a good sign.
No, he's okay. He's gonna be all right. He'll wake up soon. I talked to Bob Winslow. He's in Hawaii, and he knows this Wyman fella. He says we're in good hands. You know what's what.
Good. I'm gonna go get a cup of coffee and stay with Casey.
Finnegan?
Oh, yeah, but the girl said that she thought you were... I just didn't want to walk into the boys' room alone, you know.
Do I?
I'm sorry, Paul Finnegan, huh? Howard's dad.
Howard's dad?
Yeah, Howard's dad. I was just passing through L.A., and I've been living in Riverside for a number of years. Ola filled me in on what was going on around here.
Ola?
Yeah, Ola. How's the boy?
Well, he has a head injury, a little clot and some swelling. But they don't have to operate. We're a little worried because he won't wake up. Huh. So you're Howard's dad.
Yeah.
Well, it was very thoughtful of you to come by.
Yeah, well, hey, I was going to come by, but I just heard about this now. You know, I've never even seen him. You know, Kevin?
Casey.
Casey, yeah. Yeah, Casey.
Who's Ola?
Ola?
Oh,
that's my aunt. Right.
That's who your father talked to.
What happened to the Willis boy?
He's in surgery. So when did you talk to him last? He lives in Riverside. That's not that far away.
Well, I don't know. This is as much of a surprise to me as it is to anybody. I mean, I haven't seen him in years. I haven't talked to him since the divorce.
I wonder why he picked now.
Hi, Dad.
Hey, son. You are looking good.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry to hear about what happened to
Casey.
The kid. Oh, I'm sure he's going to be fine.
Yeah. You met Ann.
Oh, sure. Yeah, sure. Yeah. I've seen you a couple of times on television there. You're a real authority.
Huh? Yeah. So, it's a bit of a surprise.
Yeah.
How'd you find us?
It's Ola.
So, how you been?
Pretty good. You know.
Well, I'm gonna go back with Casey. It was nice to meet you.
Yeah, wasn't it?
I'll see you back there, honey. I will for a little bit. Maybe you'll wake up if I'm not here.
Yeah, well, when you get home, just sit and rest or get something to eat or just have a bath. And let's try to just forget about it, okay? Everything's gonna be all right.
Excuse me. I'm sorry. I didn't know you were asleep. I think your son is in the room next to my grandson, you know? At least I assume it's your son. I'm not from around here. I'm just here because the kid got hit by a car.
Well, are you the father of that newsman on Channel 9?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, well, I'm new. This is my wife, Dora.
Hi, Paul Finnegan. Yeah. Oh, it's your wife?
Yeah.
No, you
yeah.
two.
I'm sorry to hear about your grandson.
Yeah, he got a cracked skull and a concussion. No, he's going to be all right, but they said he's in shock right now.
Well, our son, Brian, he's been operated on twice. Somebody shot him on the freeway.
What?
Yes.
Yeah, he was just...
Yeah, just driving along, not minding his own business, and somebody shot him.
Oh, my God, what's the world coming to?
No, but nobody knows who did it.
Jesus.
Really right.
Well, ours was like a hit and run, too.
Oh. Hello, Howard?
No, this is not Howard.
Oh, I'm sorry. Who are you calling?
Casey. I want to talk about that little bastard, Casey.
Casey? Who is this? Hello?
You know what your mother said to me? I don't want you around anymore. I'll get through this thing alone better. No matter what happens to Howard. I had to respect her wishes, Howard. I mean, whether I wanted to or not, I had to. Christ, I kept thinking, you know, someday, the truth will come out, you know, and she'll understand. We both know that never happened, so.
Mr. Finnegan? Excuse me, Mr. Finnegan, you have a telephone call. It's Mrs. Finnegan. Oh, you can use that phone right there.
Yeah, hi. Everything's okay here. You all right?
I'm coming back to the hospital. Do you want me to bring you anything?
Why? You should get a good night's sleep. In case he's going to be all right.
I'm not staying here. That crazy person keeps calling. I'm scared to death.
Well, don't answer the phone. I mean, maybe it's the driver from the car. Maybe she's feeling guilty or something.
It's a man.
Well, don't worry. I mean, I'm here with Casey. The
doctors and the nurses are there with him all the time. He's going to be all right.
No, I'm coming.
No, I wish you wouldn't. Honey. You finish your coffee. I got to get back.
Brian, you know, the Negro boy in 111, I think he was operated on yesterday. Could I inquire about his condition?
Oh, yeah, he's doing very well. Yeah. He's out of critical condition. We'll be taking him out of the ICU today.
Oh, that's nice. Thanks. Excuse me just one minute.
Excuse me. What exactly is a diuretic?
It makes him urinate.
I see. So that's like to alleviate pressure.
Yeah, okay, I'll be right there.
I want to thank you for saving my son's life. You are a miracle worker.
My job.
Thank you for minor surgery.
Are you clear about this? Mr. Perry, I'm sorry. I knew that. I just was hearing the good news. Congratulations. I can't tell you how pleased I am.
Oh, thank you very much. Yeah. I mean, everybody has been so nice.
Casey, we love you, honey. Please wake up.
It's okay. Any change in my grandson? Did you know?
I'm sorry, I don't have any additional information.
Casey? Hey, sweetie. Hey, sweetie.
Well, my dad was saying that.
Casey. Howard!
How's your little boy?
Howard, Casey's waking up. Look, yeah. Look, his eyes are open.
Oh. Hey, Case. Hey, Case. Hey, buddy, how you doing? Hey, can you hear me?
Casey.
Hey, son.
Hi.
Hey, Casey.
Casey?
Hey, Case, can you hear?
Howard? Howard, what's that?
Casey.
Howard, what's happening?
Nurse! Howard? Nurse! Come here!
Hurry up!
Come here!
Hey,
I think he's breathing.
Casey, are you
okay? He opened his eyes and then he started breathing. Casey,
call a code
Casey,
blue.
Get me some
Casey.
Help.
Casey,
can you hear me?
Blue.
Son?
I see you.
Casey.
Casey.
Casey. Casey.
Casey.
Casey.
No. Casey.
Let
the
doctors
work,
please.
We have to go.
Casey.
Really
Casey.
Casey.
Come on. Come on.
No,
come on. We'll wait outside. We'll be right outside. Just give him a room. Just give him a room to work. Just give him a room.
Get the bed. Pull it up.
Please, I'm sure you'd be more comfortable. You don't want to... Get out of here!
Let's put him up. Let's check the place.
Oh.
Let me get the bag. Nothing. No. 0.4 of epinephrine, please. After that, you can drop 0.4 back. It's going to take us 4 times to CPR.
Okay, actually,
how long have we been doing this?
2 minutes.
Good. Check your pulse.
What?
Casey's birthday cake.
What is it?
I know he made the phone calls. The baker, Mr. Big Cower. Stop, don't.
I'm not open yet. The bakery's closed for business.
We can see you're closed, but I'm sure you'll see us. Mr. Big Cower!
Hey, you're not allowed in here.
Mr. Big Cower.
What do you want?
I'm Casey's mother. This is Casey's father.
I'm busy. You come back when I'm open.
No.
All right. You want your cake now? Is that it? You finally want the cake you ordered?
I want to talk to you about the cake that wasn't picked up.
Or paid for.
You're a terrible person, Mr. Big Cower.
It cost me time and money to make that cake.
Yeah.
I have work to do. I don't want to talk to you.
Yeah, well, you're going to talk to her. I'm going to knock you on your ass, pal.
How can you be so cheap and insensitive?
Lady, I work 16 hours a day to make ends meet.
Yeah.
I bake all night and work all day.
You bake all night? I thought you made phone calls at night, you bastard.
I'll call somebody. Get out of my store. I don't want any trouble here.
My son is dead. He is dead, Mr. Big Cower. He was hit by a car the day I came in here to order the cake. We have been waiting with him until he died. And now he is dead. He is dead! You bastard! You bastard! Goddamn you! Goddamn you! Goddamn you!
Shame on you. Shame.
Wait. Wait, don't go. Don't go. Don't go. Wait. Let me get you a chair. Here, sit down.